being rewarded with food. So the bird isn't acting independently.
Welcome to 1 Minute Monday. I'm your host, Ryan O. Today we're going to talk about the experimental analysis of behavior in under 1 minute. A lot of you just scroll down, you're like, this is a 3 minute video. What? I'll explain. So there are three pillars of behavior analysis right here. We're going to talk about just this one, the experimental analysis behavior. It is a method of investigation used in the field of behavior analysis, the science of behavior. It involves breaking down really complex environment behavior relations and their component principles. You see, the analysis is verified by using experimental procedures, really, really well controlled procedures to understand whether or not the basic principles, that analysis that we formed, actually holds up true when you look at human behavior or any other species of behavior. So the goal is to try to understand these controlling variables, what influences your behavior. And it's characterized by a few different things. First of all, really intense investigation with single subjects, that is one subject at a time. And so you'll see that this is in contrast to group studies, what most areas of science as well as psychology really like to investigate. But the argument is there is no one average person. We should really be zooming in and looking at individual behavior, figure out what holds across, you know, different species and humans in general. However, we should also make sure that we're looking at those idiosyncratic, those individual specific variables. And last, but certainly not least, rate response is the fundamental unit of behavior that we track and measure. What we mean by that is a count over time, or that's days, weeks, minutes, months, years. It's that simple. Although this has shifted in recent decades. All right, did I make it? Listen, there are literally over 80 years at least of this experimental branch that you can go and learn about. It's a robust area of science. Now, I wanted to include some really fascinating things, which is how much goes into really understanding these basic principles. Because people are like, am I really, you know, sharing similarities with, I don't know, bees, single-celled organisms, rabbits, dogs, rats? And the thing is yes, to some degree, but there's a lot of differences as well that have been investigated. So one of the primary ways that they would collect data is through a cumulative recorder. You can see it here. And Skinner, in 1938, Behavior of Organisms, when that book came out, there was over 4,000 charts that were included in that, individual studies. That's a total of 2 million responses that were summarized, but only 99 of these were actually published. You can look at Förster and Skinner. In 1957, they published the Schedules of Reinforcement book. Check this out. Listen. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? 250 million individual responses were recorded to make a total of 70,000 individual experiments and charts, and 896 of those made it into the final publication. If you think that's crazy, you're like, Ivan Pavlov in 1928 published 21 experiments summarizing 14 years of research from a total of over 500,000 different individual programs, research programs. Can you even imagine 14 years? Yeah, I mean, how many would you have to do per day? How many would you even have to do per day? Do you know, like, that's, hold on, let's figure this out. Only 113 per day. That's it. That's insane. That's nuts. All right, so I pulled these stats from a couple books that I really like. I've linked them both down below. The first one is Skinner on Measurement. That's where those stats came from. The second one is from this gem, Behavior Analysis and Learning. This is an older edition, also linked down below. Really cool approach to understanding the experimental analysis behavior and how it actually applies to our day-to-day life. My favorite one, if anybody knows it out there, is one talking about overdose effects. Why rock stars potentially overdose is due to this compensatory response. Maybe that's something we can talk about in the future. Let me know if you're interested down below. All right, those are linked down below for any of you budding behavior analysts. I will see you in the next one. Come and get
in. Let me kiss you in slow motion in the kitchen. Slow dance, midnight.
So if you're really into this and looking for more content, there's a long form discussion on a podcast that we host called The Controversial Exchange that dropped yesterday. It's with my friends Anita and a new colleague of mine, Matt, and my good co-host, Dimitri. We talk about whether or not the experimental analysis of behavior is still breathing. You need to listen in as Dimitri and I talk to two people that are active in that community, learn about what is actually going on in the day-to-day, how is it still relevant, what are the pressures that they face, and what are the systems issues, for example, the BACB training system, that might be affecting the lifeblood of this experimental approach. Really encourage you to check it out. It's a really fantastic discussion, and that's your Daily EA. We went way over a minute, right? Way over 3 minutes.